Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys, girls, madams, messieurs, and senoritas. Welcome along to our little show.
Can I ask you something?
Yes, I give you permission.
Thank you. What was all that about?
What do you mean, what was all that about?
Well, what you just said.
What did I just say?
You know, ladies and gentle, willkommen, willkommen, ying tong little eye po, ladies and jelly spoons, birds.
You mean the ladies and gentlemen bit?
That bit. Hmm.
Ah, well, I'm glad you noticed. You see, I thought it'd be nice to welcome people as we are being viewed across the entire globe.
You mean Giggleswick?
No. As we live in a very multicultural society, I thought it'd be nice, my little friend, to welcome those of a national and international origin to our show.
Does that mean we're on that bookface and twatter?
Twitter.
Did she?
Yes, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, you name it, and we're going to be all on it.
That sounds horrible.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, it's that time of year.
It's Christmas!
Thank you. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it is Christmas. And we're going to start off our little festive show by cracking on with some jokes.
Oh yes, it is a belter to get you started, folks. What Santa delivers presents?
Excuse me, can I have a word?
Yes.
What did I say to you before the show started?
Don't be fly.
No.
Don't eat that ready meal.
No.
Why are you putting that Christmas decoration there?
No. I said before the show started that I would feed you the line and you would do the punch. What are you doing that for?
You said do the punch.
The punch line! Punch line! Punch line! Of the joke.
Oh.
I would feed you the line and... right. Should we start again? Should we start again?
Okay. Hello! Hey, welcome to the Christmas
Not
show!
Not that far! Not that far! Oh, the jokes!
The jokes!
Joke number one.
Oh!
Joke number one. Who brings presents to cats at Christmas?
Frost flakes!
Joke number two. What do elves eat at Christmas?
Santa Paws!
No, not Santa Paws!
Eh?
It's the wrong punchline! Punchline! Right, I'll do it, right? Okay? Right. I'll do the jokes, right?
Right.
You feed me. Well, what do you
feed you?
No, I said you feed me!
Come on!
You feed me!
Me, I've got you, Ma! You've got them all!
I've been the first one!
Punchline. Oh. Folks, I think we'd better let him eat his pork pies. Have a lovely show. Enjoy. I have a reservation.
What?
I have booked a room.
What?
I have booked a room. A doctor what?
One moment, please. What?
I have a room!
There's no need to shout, I'm not deaf!
You could have fooled me.
What?
Room.
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 What?
What?
Room.
Room.
What?
Room.
What?
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 That's correct.
Name?
I just said it. What?
What?
Gordon Bennett!
Geo!
No! What? Doctor, what?
Oh, why didn't you say so? Miss, what?
Sorry?
Room 123.
What?
Room 12.
Thank you. Oh, I almost forgot. Could my Japanese mistress have an extra towel? Hu Ling.
Who?
Ling, oh, forget it. There now follows an advert about bins. Rubbish!
Now on S&P TV, we present Shakespeare's recently discovered lost Christmas play, The Merry Christmas of Windsor, dramatised by the National Middle-Aged Vic Drama Society, starring Sir Patrick Jacoby as Sir Jacoby Patrick.
try to imagine a house that's not at home. Try to imagine a Christmas all alone. That's where I'll be since you left me. My tears could melt the snow. What can I do without you? With no place to go. It'll be lonely this Christmas without you to hold. It'll be lonely this Christmas, lonely and cold. Oh, so cold and lonely without you to hold.
This is Greg. Greg is from Yorkshire. See how he struggles carrying his heavy shopping. For just 2p a year, you can help Greg survive in his native environment. Sponsor a Yorkshireman today and receive your free, yes free, broken pencil. Go on. Give what you can and help this Yorkshireman cope in his life. For more information, visit ebuygum.com.
English 3 and Club Berfran 1.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Hi, mate. Yeah, you far away. I'm listening.
Oh, excuse me.
Yeah?
Would you mind if I sit here?
Yeah, mate.
Oh, thank you very much. Take the weight off my feet. Oh, what a day it's been already. A lovely day.
You really think so?
Well, there's no cloud about.
It could happen at any time.
Well, that is true, very true indeed, yes.
Sounds like he's a right old
hobnob. Oh, please yourself.
How's your bird?
Pardon?
Your woman?
Oh, she's not too bad. I've just been to town and brought herself a nice pair of...
Knickers?
No, slippers.
Bit of a raver, is she?
Well, no, not really. She can't get up the stairs these days without holding on to my
soul.
Hand. Now, why would she want to hold on to my...
Soul, mate. You know, soul. It's a fish.
Is it? Well, I'm more of a...
Breast or leg?
I'm a tuna person myself. At my age, I can't get hold of the...
Knock it.
Bones.
All right. Ah, now I follow you, mate. So, when's the next time you'll be seeing her, then?
As soon as my bus comes. You see, I'm not very good carrying shopping. I've sprained my wrist doing a bit of...
Knock it.
No. Bowling. You young people today, all you think about is sex.
Taking her right up the...
Hole! Look at that nasty hole. Do you know, someone could have an accident fall into that hole.
I know. Mm.
To be honest, the council should do something, but they're all a bunch of...
Bankers?
Well, them too.
Do you think Footsie will be down today then, mate?
Well, you should know, you've got the...
Big dick?
Paper, mate. Paper. Dear Lord, your hearing needs to get sorted. Trouble is with you young people today, you're absolutely
bonkers. Hey, I can believe that.
Anyway, I better go and find my
saucy bitch.
See you later.
Are you bloated? Not had a poo today? Had a fluttering feeling for a couple of hours? Dreamt that you were sat in a tree? Wished you could fly? Then you could be suffering from irritable owl syndrome. Try Twitterhoot, the fast-acting irritable owl syndrome reliever today. A gallon of Twitterhoot a day, and you'll be saying goodbye to those owls sooner than you think. Try Twitterhoot today, the fast-acting irritable owl syndrome reliever. Try yours today for only 375 shillings. Hoot, and the owls have gone.
Very nice to be with you here again. I think I'll tell you a little Christmas story, shall I? Here we go then. Well, I was walking down the road the other day and I saw a man shoveling snow. I said to him, do you get my drift? He took me to see a family of elves working in the subway. They weren't supposed to be working there, but the shop was short-staffed. Now, we all went into a cafe then and sat down at the table, just to give us a bit of food for thought, and pursued through the menu. We were going to plump for the chicken. Well, the table next door to us egged us on. Then we thought about going for the bacon, but we had to lean back first. When the waitress came over, she asked us what we'd like to drink. I said, wine, please, as we were in good spirits, but I didn't really have the bottle for Coke. Well, on the way to McDonald's, we saw good King Wenceslas ordering a pizza. Apparently, he likes his deep pan crisp and even. Well, we walked a bit further down the Christmas road and we saw Scrooge playing football. He won the game, actually, because of a lucky tackle. You know why, though, don't you, folks? Well, the ghost of Christmas past. Well, I went home after that and snuggled into bed after a nice cup of cocoa. And I heard sleigh bells. I couldn't believe it. I was quite excited. I crept downstairs and I saw Father Christmas's cat. True story, this. He's called Santa Paws. And there he was himself, Santa Claus himself, walking backwards and muttering a few words. Oh, oh, oh. As he saw me, he chuckled to himself and got on his Holly Davidson to ride out of there. He put the best of Elvis Presley on, that's his CD, and zoomed into the sky, probably going back to see Merry Christmas, his wife. He gave me a wink at the end, it was so special, and said, I must go, Greg, I've burnt myself on your chimney. No wonder they call me Crisp Kringle. Well, you have a very Merry Christmas, folks, and a very successful 2017.
What appears to be your problem?
Well, you see, I bought a model from your range the other day, but I noticed a few add-ons.
I see. Can you tell me about your model?
Well, you see, it's one of your locality range.
I see. When was the first time you noticed the fault?
Well, to be honest, it was rather an intimate moment over the weekend.
Have you been dating long, Mr. Prick?
No.
Is this your first time?
Yes.
I see.
You know, if it really wasn't for the add-ons, I wouldn't mind. I mean, what a package.
Is this your product, Mr. Prick?
Oh, yes. That's my beautiful, lovely Leslie.
What a woman.
Les.
Pardon?
Formerly a Mr. Les Roberts from Nookie Pussy, one of our mid-oppy ranges.
I'm sorry?
When you first ordered your product, Mr. Fanny, did you read the product specifications?
No, I have trouble with my eyes.
Did you read the small writing on the back of the flyer?
Oh, may contain nuts.
Good day, Mr. Pussy.
And stop there.
Well, that's the end of the story, ladies and gentlemen.
We haven't got it. He's been Pep.
And he's been Pep. And remember, folks, no matter how bad the world gets, a little bit of laughter and your troubles really will fly away. Have a very Merry Christmas.
And here we are on the behind the scenes of Cellos and Pep's new special Christmas show, A Christmas Cracker. And here we are in front of Mr. Gregory Cellos. Good afternoon, Mr. Cellos.
Hey, up. How are you doing? All right.
How are you today?
I'm very good, thank you. Very excited.
Are you excited? Yes. Why are you excited?
Well, it's the filming today, you know. It's the filming for a very special production.
What production are you involved in?
That would be telling.
And are you enjoying yourself so far, being on this extraordinary location?
Oh, definitely, definitely. I mean, there's Hollywood, there's Broadway, and then there's this.
And what place do you call this?
Gilbert.
Sorry, I've just gone out to another. I'm
then.
Oh, I've heard that!
Someone could have a nasty accident in that hall.
You're in pain.
I'm going to wee at the same time.
You're constipated.
Do you like one to come out?
Lonely and cold.
really can change people's lives. Done. Yeah, I'm happy with that. I know it fell off a bit, but it was quite...